So we'll now check the firmware update of MVH-A219BT and AVH-A219BT, how to do the firmware update. For that, first we need a USB drive, and we have to first format this USB drive on FAT32. So let me just connect this to this laptop. So I can see this USB drive here. I'll right click and format this on this FAT32. Now the USB is ready to use. I'll do the firmware update of MVH-A219BT. So I'll go in this folder, and there are three update files. These are the firmware update files for this particular unit. I have to copy all three of them. So I have to just copy these three files here. Please remember not to create any new folder. Just put these three files into the root folder in the open space of the USB drive. So once this is done, then you can disconnect the USB from your laptop. Now to update the firmware in the unit, we have to take this USB drive and connect it with the unit. We have to activate the firmware update mode. For that, we have to press volume plus and next key at the same time and reset the unit. So I'll keep these two keys pressed, and now we will reset the unit. So now we have entered the firmware update mode. So in this mode, in the very first option that you see, software information and version up. So you press home button. Home is like OK button. You enter in the next menu. In this menu you see two options, software info and version up. So you press volume minus to go down in version up, and then press home to go into the version up mode. Now the unit will automatically proceed to the next step and the firmware update will start. Please remember that we have to do this firmware update twice. So this is the first time that the firmware update is being done on the unit. Once this procedure is done and this bar shows complete, then we'll do the firmware update again using the same files. The first time firmware update is done. Now we have to do it again, but before doing that we have to come back to the normal mode by pressing the reset key, and the unit will reboot. Now the unit has come to normal mode. Now with the same pen drive connected to the unit, we will do the firmware update again. Following the same procedure,
we'll press the volume plus and next key. Keep them pressed and press the reset key. As you can see, we have come back to the firmware update mode, and here we press home to come to the next screen. Now we press volume minus to go down to version up option. Then we again press home. Home means OK here. Now with this screen, the unit will automatically detect the next firmware update file and will automatically start the firmware update. The second firmware is being updated, and as you can see, it will be updated to 8.04 version. And in some head units, it will be 8.05. So you have to remember 8.04 and 8.05 for certain units. Now the firmware updation has completed. So it has been completed twice, as we have seen in the video. Now we can press the reset key and the unit will be ready to use. Our firmware update has been completed. Now we can disconnect the USB from the unit. Now we'll try to connect a phone which is on Android 9 version. This is Galaxy Note 8. This is on Android version 9. Now we'll connect this with the unit.